Hi everyone, welcome back to WLG Academy and welcome back to Introduction to Programming Using Java. Since we already know how the switch works, let's do a very simple exercise. So basically we have to create a program where this program is going to print weekday for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and weekend for Saturday and Sunday based on the number entered by the user. So consider 1 for Sunday, 7 to Saturday, and any other number should display the message invalid input. So there are different ways, I can think at least of 3 different ways of doing this exercise, but I would like you to use switch. We can use if and else, we can use the switch before Java 13, and we can use switch after Java 13. So try to do in a way that you probably already know how to do it, and then if your way is different from what I'm going to do here, you can just refactor or even create another class. So let's do this. We already have a package. Now, how do we create a class inside the package? Right here. Out insert, and then we add here Java class, exercise, conditionals 07. Okay, so since we have a package, now the first thing that we are going to notice is that we have a package instruction here. If we remove this, oops, we are going to have a problem because we have to tell where this class is located. That's why IntelliJ is adding this package for us. And remember, all the structures, they should either end with semicolon or curly braces. In this case, it needs to be semicolon. Okay, I'm going to copy the exercise here. I'm going to add it here. And then we are going to start. So we first need scanner. Scanner. I'm going to change the name instead of keyboard or input. And now it's going to be scanner. And then system.in. Okay. Now, we do have here the way to get the data from the user. So what is the data that we need to get from the user? We should get a number. So it's either 1 or 7. So let's type here, salt, type the number of the day of the week. Consider 1 for Sunday and 7 for Saturday. Okay, so we have here pressing Alt 1 to hide the project view. And then we have here the nice message. We are going to now ask the user to actually type something. So next int. So what is this? Alt enter, introduce local variable. This is the day. So the first thing is let's just do the validation right before we even go. So we have two options to do this. We can do the validation before, have like if the day is not one of these numbers, what can we do? We can just print a message here and stop the program. Or we can do it using switch. So let's just do it using switch. Looks like this could be, leave it like that. Okay, so switch day. Okay, so we have kind of the same message for most of the days. So case, I'm going to use the new version. Case, this is either 1 or 7. So if the day is 1 or 7, what do I want to do? I want to print a message saying, hey, ooh, nice, now it's weekend. If not, it's either 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are going to print the message, salt, press tab, weekday. And what if it's any other option? That's why we have the default here. So you have different ways. You could have if and check if is not either one, if it's like kind of below 1 or greater than 7, then you should just send a message. And this way, your program would not reach the switch at all. But this way, we are just going to do the same using the switch statement. Invalid input. Cool. Now, let's execute Ctrl-Shift-F10. 1, okay, weekend, 2, big day, and let's say we are typing here 22, invalid input. So that's it for this exercise. We are doing exactly what we were asked to do. And as you can see, it's pretty straightforward. So if you did it with if else, like 7 or 8 times, it's okay too as well. But as you can see, there are different ways, a way that's cleaner, a way that people can understand a little bit faster than if they had to read all the if and else's. Now to format this code, Control Alt L, and you can see that's even a little bit more organized. So that's it. Let's continue in the next video. Bye-bye.